it just didn't feel right in terms of, because it's just something that when I said it, I've been playing lacrosse here at Mississippi State since I was a freshman, and these are my best friends. And I've, you know, done so much with these guys and been through so much with these guys, not only on the field but off the field. You know, because yeah, this is just, it's just club. It's not like it's anything more than that. But at the same time, it is. You know, and we've been doing this for so long, and it's a sport that I love and that I've given myself to. And to, you know, kind of close the chapter and move on to something new is, it's been, it was difficult. But in the midst of that sadness, you know, I was fortunate enough to just embrace it and be thankful for everything that's happened.
Play first though, and then he gets to make the decision after.
Dogs on three! One, two, three, dogs!
You know, in October, you just, it's just tough, you know, and especially, like I said, when not a lot of guys are showing up, and it's raining, you know, it's muddy, maybe you've been kicked around to different fields. You know, it makes you question sometimes why you play, but at the end of the day, this is what we love. We've been playing lacrosse, you know, for a long time.
When it rains, the mesh of the stick, it gets wet, it droops, the pocket gets deeper, the ball slides out easier, throwing and catching is harder. It's a chore to get used to that, to you know, adjust on the fly. Even during those conditions, like, nobody ever wants to go practice in those conditions, but you know, everybody knows that you can't, unless it's impossible for you to play, you got to get out there to play competitively against other teams that you desperately want to beat on a regular basis. You have to out-practice them to get to that point.
Based on the expectations that I heard from you guys and from the other coaches coming into the season, we really need to get back to that point, like, if we want to do those things that you guys want to do. All right, but I thought, you know, overall, it's always good out to get out and play and have a good time. Everyone thank Carter for coming out tonight.
This is my first semester here. I came from Ohio State. I'm a grad student here.
How are we setting up here? Is that a Y or is that an L?
My role as a coach, it's kind of a mix between playing and coaching. So I like to mix it up a little bit. I'll get involved sometimes, and then other times I'll step back and kind of make sure it's being ran correctly. But then when we go to live scrimmage type of play, then I like to hop in there just to keep my legs fresh.
Hey, attack! I need you guys starting at the top of the box every time.
He came to our first meeting, and you know, he's this short, little, stocky guy. I wasn't expecting that. And what he brings for us in practice, I mean, he knows what he's doing. He can coach us while he plays with us. And you know, a banker, climb the ladder, and you know, they'll give me, you know, an idea of what to do during the game. We're getting pretty good recruits in now, and you know, they've played before. They have great talent. Our freshman class is amazing this year. Especially our defense. I was very impressed with the defense this past tournament that we went to. And just the way we came together as a team this fall, we definitely have the most potential we've ever had in the past 4 years since I've been here.
I see the shot go off and goes whistling by, and you look up and the ball is tracking right for the cameraman. Oh!
In the leg. Yeah.
I mean, everyone just kind of stopped and it just went bang, hit him right. I mean, just, you know, right there.
The ball gets passed over on the left to Jake Pyatt. A freshman attackman. And Jake sees that his defender isn't really playing him very hard, so he takes a step in and he unleashes one of his signature sidearm rocket shots right at the top right corner that he likes to shoot.
It was hilarious, first of all. But Jake's the one that threw the ball. I could have picked that out of anybody. I heard he was shooting, and the camera, all you heard was, oh, and hit the ground.
It was Jake. Jake just winds up and lets one go, and the camera dude.
Like, I saw sheer panic. Yeah. Like, it was like, he was so afraid. Yeah.
I didn't know. I just saw him holding this area.
Yeah.
So I didn't know if it was, I didn't know what had happened. Did you see it, Adam?
I did. I saw Jake, and when it went by me, I flipped around and saw a very, very scared cameraman who just down.
Yeah, just
and I'm
dropped.
Like, I know exactly what he's feeling right now.
But one of the difficulties of club sports is that there is a discrepancy between the business sides of things with the different clubs, and so you can schedule the game with the team, and then a day or two before the game, a lot of teams will just like, oh, we don't want to show up. Whereas a lot of other teams are much more professional, and you're able to carry through with your schedules and honor all of your agreements. So, in this case, we had scheduled with a team that isn't very professional, University of Memphis, and they backed out on us, and we couldn't find a replacement team in time. So, that's why the game got canceled.
It's definitely a letdown when you don't get to play. But that's the reality of the club world. You've got college students interacting with other college students, trying to schedule things, and sometimes things don't work out. We've made strides to be as professional as we can and present ourselves as a virtual varsity program, not only on the field, but in this case off the field with the scheduling, with just the logistics. Not every team is as professional, and there's some tension there.
There's a lot of times where things out of our control really change our plans and change what we're going to do. We'll have plans for 2 or 3 months, and then something will happen. Some team will say, "Oh no, we're going to go into debt if we don't, skip this game and forfeit this game." It's like, it's a conference game. You agreed to it 6 months ago. You shouldn't have bought your whole team brand new helmets instead of playing us. But it comes with the price of being a club.
Pretty clear that nobody ever really wants to travel down to Tupelo, Mississippi, because nobody's ever heard of Tupelo, Mississippi. It's really tough getting teams to come play us here at home with a state that there's not much lacrosse at all here in Mississippi, so it's a chore trying to get people to come play us.
There's no name associated.
You're paying me $18 right now?
Yeah.
Well, technically, no.
I need a meeting.
We're students, and we've got tests, and we've got, friends. We've got other things that we're involved with, whether it be church or other organizations on campus. And so balancing that with being able to play the sport that we love and doing all the business side of things, it can be a real challenge.
Let's see there with that.
You should try and top him. Just try and jump over the ball and beat him. All right, down.
Coach Brian has been around since day one for me, and he played at Tennessee. He was their goalie, and it was actually maybe not too long ago, maybe 10 years, But he's kind of been the figurehead, and even though he doesn't have as much experience in lacrosse as the other coaches, he's been a great leader and really egging the team on and pushing us in the right direction. Coach Moffitt came along a little bit after that, later on in the season, my freshman year or sophomore year. He played at North Carolina and was on the championship team in 91, 92, and 93. And just his experience with the defense, he was able to implement certain defense and different slides and what we do in this position, what we do in that position. We were able to really do a lot last year. There's only two ways out.
Right now, the first game will be at 2 o'clock, so then we may not leave till 9:30, which will be nice. But you never know what's gonna happen with Garrett.
9:30 a.m.
You never know.
Yeah. 9 at night.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Okay.
No, yeah. 9:30. If not, if they move back up to 12, it'll be 7:30. We leave. There is no championship game.
Oh.
So right now we're slated to play 2 games against UTC in Memphis. So Alex will be texting y'all either tonight or tomorrow whenever Garrett figures it out.
Do we know what the weather will look like?
Yes. It's supposed to be a really good day.
Where's weatherman west?
5 degrees, 5 mile an hour winds out of like the southwest.
Who needs weather west when we got weather bend?
Oh, dang it. Southwest?
Parameter bend.
I hate it when they're southwest.
Just went to NOAA. That's the best way to check.
We beat Memphis, I think, 17-6. We really, really were successful against them. And they're a great team. They have some exceptional players, particularly on the offensive side of the field. And our defense did a great job containing their shooters, getting out on their hands, and we were tough on ground balls all day long. And offensively, we had more scores than I think we've ever had as a team.
That was a real morale booster for us. And then after that, we played UT Chattanooga.
And since there are only 3 teams, it was round robin, and we ended up being the team that had to play back-to-back. We had maybe a 30-minute break. If we didn't have the 30-minute break, I think we would have pulled out against Chattanooga, but we lost by 4 goals.
They had fresh legs and they had a whole lot more people than we did, but we hung with them all the way up until the end. We lost 12-8, but up until the fourth quarter, it was a really close game, and all the guys were tired, but everybody kept running. We were all gassed, and we played our hearts out, and that's really all you can ask in a situation like that.
It was weird all semester because I knew that I was going to, I had sent out an application for a congressional internship, and didn't think much, and that I didn't think I'd get it. And when I got word, not long ago about that I had been accepted and offered the position. It was tough, because of lacrosse, like I said, is so important to me.
So not a lot of people know this, but this is the last practice of my career as an athlete. That's weird.
It's called coaching right there.
Pretty crazy. Very thankful, and just want to make this weekend count.
When he announced it, we all kind of looked at each other and we knew it was coming, and it was actually pretty, I had already come to terms with it, but it was pretty sad to see the faces of some of the other guys who had no idea, Brando especially. Brando and Ben are really close, and I know Brando was disappointed to hear that.
I got up. see Ben Hester. He's been MVP since my freshman year. He noticed that I was becoming a little bit better than him. He didn't like that. He didn't like that at all. Not one bit. Not one bit.
I think I was one of the first ones that he called and told kind of what was up, that he might be getting a really good opportunity in the spring, and I'm so excited for him. It's a heartbreaker that he's going to be gone, but I'm really excited for him. And just when he told me, he's always talked about he wants that championship, and that's the only thing I think about.
Chip on your shoulder, boys. Come on.
We are safe!
And there were times this weekend when I was playing that, you know, I was almost overcome with, you know, I would pass the ball to somebody who'd feed somebody, and then, you know, Brandon Owens would score. And, you know, just running up, little things like running up and hugging as a team, you know, celebrating after a goal. You know, I was thinking in some of those moments about, man, this is sort of surreal. You know, so thankful for my friends on this team, and so thankful for, you know, the ability to play it. You know, I'm a Christian, and, you know, just I've felt in the midst of my sadness over having to leave this, and I have felt an incredible comfort through my faith, and knowing that, you know, I'm just blessed to be able to have played it and to be able to have done what's happened, and to have met the guys that I met, and to still have them as friends, and know that they're my brothers and my family. I'm just very thankful.
Yeah, I think it's going to have a big effect on the team. He's definitely one of those players, not just what he produces statistically on the field, but he's also kind of one of those leaders that other guys look to. A lot of times when you lose a player like that, it gives a team an opportunity to actually come together more as a team and to play better as a team.
We can definitely win without Ben out there. He's great, and he's MVP every game. But you know, we have come together as a team, and we are strong as a team. And you know, with Brando, I mean, he and I, we talked, and you know, we really want to step it up and, you know, encourage the younger guys, because we have the talent on this team to win the conference.
Month of practice.
Sounds
own him.
But he has the sound system.
Own him.
I broke your spirit.
Turn around.
Hey!
Oh, there's some
that's some
healthy lettuce.
Luscious.
That is so very nice.
Head and shoulders.
Coach Gons riding away.
Yeah.
Hey, Coach Gons, we got a bike pump at our place if you need one.